This video will show you how to sync any sample to the project tempo in FL Studio. There's a couple of different ways to do this depending on the sample and what you're trying to achieve. So keep on watching, and I'll show you how to do it right after this.
This is a Firewalk production.
If you're just starting out with FL Studio, you probably know that you can easily drag and drop samples into the playlist. However, they will not always be in the correct tempo. Samples can generally be placed into two categories. First, there's the static samples, like kicks, claps, hats, and so on. Because these kinds of samples are static one-shots, the tempo doesn't really matter. The other kind is the rhythmic ones. This could be a drum loop or a vocal or a guitar part, for example. Because they contain a groove, they will have to be synchronized to the project. The first thing I'm going to do is drag a kick into the project and make it a typical 4-to-the-floor pattern, so we have something to relate to. I'll set the project tempo to 128 BPM. Now let's find a drum loop and import it into the project as well. I will deliberately choose one that has a different tempo to make sure that it will be out of sync. You can clearly hear that they are not in sync. One kick hits before the other, and you can also see it at the end here. There is a distinct gap. There's a few ways to deal with this. If you left-click on the sample's upper left corner, a menu will appear. What's interesting for us in this example are the Detect Tempo and Fit Tempo options seen here. If you click the Detect Tempo, it will attempt to figure out the tempo and display the detected tempo to you. You'll get a few options here, as you can see. I recommend you go with the 100 to 200 for the most part, unless you have a 60 BPM project or something like that. Just choose what seems right based on your project tempo. It has now detected the tempo. You can now choose to use this tempo or cancel. It doesn't always work 100%. Sometimes it may detect a 130 BPM sample as 129.975. In cases like that, it's clear that the right tempo is probably supposed to be 130. Next, let's explore the Fit to Tempo option. Left-click on the upper left corner again and choose Fit to Tempo this time. The same menu will appear. Sometimes a sample's BPM will be embedded in the sample itself. In that case, it will say Embedded behind the tempo here. In that case, just click on the button and you're done. But this sample doesn't have this information embedded. Instead, it's guessing that the sample is 130 BPM, which is actually right. As long as we know that, we could just click the button and be done. But it won't always be right, so let's continue. Below, we have the Detection BPM Range buttons. Below that again, we have the Type in BPM and Type in Beat buttons. If you know for sure what the tempo is, you can click these buttons and type in the BPM manually. For the sake of this tutorial, I'll choose to run one of the detection algorithms, so I'll click the 100 to 200 button again. As you can hear, it's now in the right tempo. Both kicks are synchronized. Let's try this again with a guitar sample. I'll deliberately choose a sample that has the wrong tempo. A lot of times, especially in high-quality sample packs, everything is usually labeled very well. Samples will typically contain both the key and the tempo in the description of the sample, or the tempo will be embedded in the file itself. That's not always the case, though, so let's continue. Again, we can clearly hear that this does not sound right at all. The guitar is way too fast. So let's left-click on the upper left corner of the guitar sample and do the same thing as we did last time. Now it's in perfect sync. The last thing I want to show you is how to do this manually. This is especially useful for vocals and other samples that have a more dynamic tempo that change over time. Some parts of the sample may be in sync while others are not. I'll delete the guitar loop and import another one. If I grab the end of the clip and drag, it will just shorten it. In order to manually stretch the sample, we need to click this little button up here. This will enable stretch mode. Now any audio sample you drag will be stretched instead. It didn't snap perfectly, so I'll press the Alt key on the keyboard while I drag, and this will enable fine-tuning. You can imagine how useful it can be to manually stretch. For example, if you want to do a remix and the tempo of the vocals varies a lot, FL Studio doesn't have audio warping the way Ableton does, but you can chop up the sample and manually stretch it instead to achieve the same thing. Don't forget to turn off audio stretching when you're done. This button is very small, so it's easy to forget. Last but not least, I want to quickly show you a few important settings in the sampler. Double-click on the sample to bring up the sampler. Because the sample is stretched, you'll notice that the time setting has been altered due to our stretching. You should pay attention to the setting here where it says Mode. There are a few different stretching algorithms available to you. They all affect the sound in different ways. The default setting is Resample. This means that as you make a sample shorter or longer, the pitch will increase or decrease. This is not always desirable. To avoid this, we can choose one of the stretching algorithms to maintain the pitch of our sample, even if it's stretched like so. This is especially useful for vocals and instruments like the guitar we just experimented with. If you want to be able to adjust the tempo of your entire project without having to adjust every single sample, once you've gotten everything synced up, you can go to Tools, Macros, and select Switch Real-Time Stretching for All Audio Clips. You can now adjust the global tempo and everything will stay in sync. There you go. Now you know how to get samples in sync with your projects. Speaking of samples, I recommend you check out my video on how to organize samples in FL Studio. This video will teach you how to work smarter and faster when it comes to samples. It's a great workflow tip that's guaranteed to save you a lot of time in the long run. You can find the link to the video in the description below. That's it! I'm uploading new tutorials and templates every week, so make sure to subscribe to this channel so that you won't miss out. I hope this was helpful. If you liked the video, please like, share, and comment. Is there any specific tutorial you'd like me to make? Or perhaps you have a question? Just leave me a comment below.